Can a MacBook Pro from 2009 still be good in 2023? In this video, we're gonna find out. So this is a 2009 MacBook Pro 15-inch, 2.53 gigahertz dual-core CPU with 8 gigs of RAM, running OS Monterey via open-core legacy patcher version 5.2 on a 256 gigabyte solid-state hard drive. The beautiful thing is that OpenCore Legacy Patcher version 5.2 fully supports this computer, and we've got all the post-installed root patches available and installed on this particular machine. Now we're going to perform a boot test from power button to ready desktop. Now keep in mind, this computer is running OpenCore Legacy Patcher version 5.2, so it's going to be slightly slower than your traditional macOS that is supported for this computer. 48.3 seconds. I mean, for a computer from 2009 running the newest Monterey, I'm not gonna say it's good, but it's not bad. One thing that I want to mention is that the trackpad on a higher sensitivity setting definitely does not feel old. It's got some very good movement to it, it's responsive, the gestures work. Definitely the trackpad, I feel like, is up to par. Okay, so now we're going to test out Google Chrome and just do some basic searches to see how fast the internet is on this unsupported version of Mac. So let's just type in cooking. Decent speed. Let's go houses. Nice. So I've got YouTube open right now, and we're just gonna play one of my videos. Let's bump it up to 1080p. Definitely some time to load. Video is playing, but doesn't look super stable, to be honest. Oh, there's the loading circle of death. Yeah, I don't think the video streaming capability on this computer is up to par when it comes to today's standards, but I mean, let's tone it down to 720. That definitely loaded up nice. Let's maximize and minimize. I mean, I can see a little bit of video lag. This is a great way to test out any internal graphics card on a computer, stream video and minimize and maximize while the video is playing. And see how the video card handles the transition from regular to full screen. I mean, you can see right here, the video is actually still playing while I maximize and minimize, so that's definitely a good sign. So when it comes to this specific computer running OpenCore Legacy Patcher on Monterey, I'd say no go for 1080p, but definitely viewable in 720 if you're streaming off YouTube. Now let's get an idea for the sound. Full volume. I mean, it's decent, but nothing crazy. Definitely hearable. Now we're gonna try opening some commonly used apps and see how fast we can get them to open. So this is Microsoft Word. I feel like the video streaming capability was a little disappointing. I mean, that wasn't super duper fast, but definitely usable for a computer of this age. Let's try Excel. A decent, but not blazing, that's for sure. Let's see how fast the computer can sleep and recover from sleep. So as soon as this light here gets blinky, we know it's in sleep mode. Any day now. Oh, we're in sleep mode, so yeah, that did take a while. Let's see how quick we can recover from sleep. Pretty fast. Another thing to keep in mind, if you are in fact in the market for a budget MacBook Pro like this one, the 15-inch model, it's pretty heavy. So in short, can this mid-2009 MacBook Pro still be good in 2023? I mean, if you're using it for online usage, very basic usage, and you don't mind a little bit of lack of speed in comparison to today's computers, then I think this is a good budget Mac. But if you want something blazing fast, if you need to open up web pages with superior speed, maybe this isn't the computer for you. And if you like to stream 1080p and that's an important feature, I would look at a different computer in comparison to this one. Full transparency on this channel as always. Appreciate all the support. Hit that like and subscribe button. Stay tuned for more.